Hi guys, I'm HeatoN here with a special episode for IEM Katowice powered by 500. And Katowice, being the biggest tournament of the year so far, has a very special place in my heart. Because in my book, it's the event that made Counter-Strike a lot what it is today. It was the first CSGO event where you had a big audience on stage and the Polish fans. Well, let me tell you, if you haven't seen a Katowice event, there's something special. It's insane. I had honors to be the coach of NIP when we played a major final versus VP. And I'm telling you, it was worse atmosphere in a good way than in a football game. It was insane. What Katowice did was, putting, a standard up for events, how they should be, and that you could actually watch esports live, and it's so much better. So thank you so much for that, Katowice, and thank you so much for that, IEM. Going into this episode, I have two topics I want to discuss. I'm going to have a betting prediction in the end. But before doing that, I just want to flag that we're hidden some codes from our partner 500 in this video. You can redeem them. First come, first serve. So check them out instantly. And you go in here to deposit. And you put it right in there. And the money will be added to your account if you're the first one doing it. So good luck with that. The two topics I want to discuss in this episode is, first off, G2. And they're being the favorites together with Vitality in my book. And I mean, the reasons why they're playing so well. Well, G2, first of all, they have a great mixture. But the number one reason in the book is that Nico is playing so goddamn well again. And, he's not maybe being outfragged sometimes by Munisi. But important frags, he's opening up the map in an insanely good well. So much information plays, so much, insane rounds. And Nico doing that, it's just insane. I would actually rank him number one or number two in the world now together with Saiwu and Simple on the third. One thing that's quite fun that to notice is that Saiwu, who's also playing great at the moment, just swapped to the new Easy Mice, the EC2 Wireless, which I made, by the way, which is awesome. And you have Nico swapping over to the Vaxi XE Wireless. And they both started performing so well when they swapped mices. And I think this whole tournament is going to come down to whoever has the best day of Saiwu and Nico, or best days, to say it. Because they're so good, both of those players right now. So it's whoever has the best tournament is going to win this event. And it's a pleasure to see, having GigaShad Hooksy struggling individually so much. He's, he's not putting up great numbers now, but it just feels so much more composed than what they did in the beginning. I think G2 are my favorites to win this event. Secondly, the dark horse of the tournament. Well, that's NIP in my book. So if you look at it, NIP has the firepower. They have the best player in Sweden, Res. They have Brolan, he's not performed as one would expect from Brolan. He's an insanely good player, just under Res in my book, but he hasn't really performed since he got to NIP. If he starts shooting this event, it's going to be insane. Because they have Alexi Bia, one of the best in-game leaders. Super smart guy. They have Hedrick, who's putting up insane numbers. Super good player. Super good AVP-er. Super talent. And now they have Config as well instead of Hampus. I think, they have the firepower. And DGL being the coach there, they can actually win this whole tournament. They're my underdogs, the dark horse for this tournament. And, If they actually can get Config in to play in Hampus' roles as one would hope, and they're also going to have the honeymoon period, so stay focused on NIP because they can do a lot of hurt in this tournament. I think they actually, on a good day, might actually go all the way. Hopes and dreams. We also have a betting prediction for this one for the first days of the tournaments. We're sending everything on my channel, on my Twitch channel, so be sure to join in there as well. We have Big versus Complexity, and Big, well, they managed to beat Liquid 2-0, but their last game was quite bad. If you look at Complexity, on the other hand, I think they've been overperforming to what you can expect from them, and I actually think this is the best of one. They have a solid chance here, but taking a more safe approach, my prediction for the game is going to be plus 3.5 rounds handicap for Complexity at 175 in odds. I mean, it's really good odds. They only need to read 13 rounds, which should be, they should do it more than 50% of the time. Quite a lot more, actually. So it's a good investment, good bet. that I'm going to do for the first days. And also be sure to tune in on our Discord, Twitter. We're going to have some insane competition and giveaways there. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and see you in Katowice.